Welcome back, everyone. I'm the Depressed Eeyore, and this is Brigandine. Let's take a look at the map real quick. As you can see, we've greatly expanded. We've more than doubled our territory ever since we began our push against Escalio and wiped them out. So our options at this point is, well, there's three, though the third option's not really one. We can either continue pushing to the east and start going after Leonia, which is a rather isolated area. As you can see, there's a choke point here and a choke point up there. So for the most part, it's not getting... You can, with one army and some effort, you can eventually wear down this entire area and then push your way out to the north. The other option, of course, is we go after Ascaris and start pushing up against, pushing north all the way up to Dorgard. And the third option, of course, is we betray New Almechia and go up this way, which isn't really an option. Well, it's an option, but it's not really intelligent. So, at this point, I'm thinking we want to start pushing our way through Ascaris. We have an ally, we might as well take advantage of that. That's my thought process on that. So what we're going to go ahead and do is we need to go ahead and start... first things first, we need to start doing some organization. That's a given. So what we're going to do here is... We have a level 10 there, a level 10... Yeah, we got monsters we need to take care of, and we're about to have a lot more monsters that are going to be upgraded and all that nonsense. So what we're going to do is we're just going to drop these monsters down here real quick and see where that takes us. Bring that up. Okay, so we'll do something like this for now and see what upgrades we get. So class-wise, we got the Hydra. So it becoming a Tiamat makes it rather strong. It's very powerful. It gets additional movement, but only in water, unfortunately, so it still moves 3 in land. Its rune cost goes up by 30, and its upkeep goes up, of course. The main thing, of course, is it gets a Dragon Roar, just like all other dragons. Its breath attack becomes 5 range and rather devastating, and they become partially dark elements, which is really rather powerful. I have made an army of nothing but Hydras and, you know, gradually converted them into Tiamats, and it's rather effective. It's just a steamrolling line of death that you just push up slowly and then do breath attacks on anything that comes by. So there we go, Tiamat. Of course we get the Coatl. Nothing too much has changed for that. It has a roar, but I never used the Dragon Roar. Now for fairies, fairies get some fancy things. They are now 2 green for that element. Green element doesn't have any weaknesses, but if you do fight with... If green elements attack green elements, it does reduce damage. In any case, protecting silence has been... two new spells is paralyze, which can be pretty useful if it hits. It's like a temporary effect, usually. It doesn't increase defense like petrification. But the big thing is React. What React does is it lets a character take 2 actions. So if a character has already taken an action and you cast React on them, that little end thing that says their turn is done will disappear and they can act again. If you cast it on someone that hasn't acted yet, they can act and then act again. So no matter what, it ensures that you get 2 actions. So with this, you can do some pretty fancy things. You can do things like rush with the dragon, do a bite attack, and then immediately do a breath attack afterwards. Or you can move a caster and then do a massive nuke. It's very expensive, it's very short range, but it's rather powerful. So we're going to go ahead and upgrade you. And okay, so at this point we need to figure out how we're going to sort all this. Unfortunately, our options are limited, so let's see what we can do here. Something like that, maybe. The good news is we can gradually filter out some of these monsters to other armies, so we have some other armies that are not just all gen. Frame rate. The question is, what do I want to drop? I'd rather, you know, have my dragons, to be honest. Even though the centaurs have been pretty helpful. But with this, we can have this set up, I guess. I'm sure our enchantress at least has some ability behind her. For Cortina over here, I can go ahead and start filtering these in. That's helpful. You can of course take all these. Daffy, I'm just gonna send you away. In fact, I might take your helmet. So, send Daffy away. And then we'll send Cortina and Victoria down that way. Actually, no, that's fine. You can do it like that. Just sending you guys up this way. And what do we have over here? Harriet's and all of them. Okay. And we could send you guys up this way. So we're at a two-front war at this point, which is helpful. It's going to go up to three temporarily. No, not temporarily, sorry. It'll be a three-front war for a little while. That's okay. Alright, let's go ahead and execute this move. And of course, we're still very much on the offense here. So, where do I want to go? Zemeckis is over here. I kinda need to deal with him. He does have a Tiamat, which is a bit annoying. Escaras does start out with a Tiamat and a Vampire Lord. And Kador's over here as well. Kador's a Death Knight, and they have their ninja over here. So all bad stuff all the time. So alright, what I want to do is I'm going to go ahead and make an attack this way towards Zemeckis. I don't want to risk him attacking this city here. We should be able to take him on. Zemeckis is pretty tough, but he's not. We should be okay. He is level 27, of course. So he actually goes first. Anyway, that's a ghoul. Zemeckis. He's an emperor. He has his own unique class. He's two red elements. Now he actually is an archer. He uses a giant crossbow that does tons of damage. He does have two spells. He has power and Geno Thunder, so he has pretty much the nastiest of the fire spells. The former commander of the Almechian army is now the emperor of the Escaras Empire. His goal is to dominate the continent by force. He looks like a demon standing on the battlefield with a giant crossbow. Over here we have Millet, who is a sorceress. She has a Thorn Whip, which increases physical attack power for pretty much sorceress classes, which is useless. A girl adopted to the Caerleon family, of whom are famous for their magic. She has a twin sister, Mira, and this fact has made their lives complicated. She pledges the reinstatement of her family with her sister and has applied to work for the Empire. Peridol, Bishop. A priest who supported the conspiracy in Almechia. He instigated the conspiracy by causing mass hysteria. He was a promising priest, but now he is simply doing it for a place in the palace. His dream is to have the power to rule the world. You know, it's good to have goals. Alright, let's get moving. Biggest issue is going to be Zemeckis. He's mobile, and his crossbow is devastating. It could potentially one-shot Melia over here if we're not careful. Especially with a crit. But I'm hoping just to wipe out somebody. And hopefully that'll help out. Oh great, it's stuttering. Okay, it fixed itself. King Kai, do you know of power? No, you don't. That sucks. Alright, I'm trying to get into a somewhat reasonable position. That's okay. Yeah, it's too close. Okay. I'll go right there. Okay. Protect on a ghoul. Okay, whatever floats your boat. Alright. Then... right there. Definitely want them to act first, even if it means the Mechas might get a first strike. Do something like that. Move you up one. You want to protect Amelia. Just in case. Because with the roads, all Zemeckis has to do is get in within 3 hexes and he can take a shot at her. Okay, and then what I want to do here is just get right there. Now, if they don't move this upcoming round, I will breath attack with my Tiamat. And that will hit 2 units. We'll shift down a little bit like this. Alright. A little bit of a wide front, that should be fine. No action. Okay. Using up your protects. Alright. Shift down one, that's fine. And that's it. So we'll go ahead and end this turn. I can't take forever, unfortunately. I have to eventually do something. So something is exactly what we're gonna do. We'll pass this turn. Death Breath. This will hit 2 units. It's not exactly the most efficient thing I could do, but it's fine. go, good hits. Do I have enough to cast Protect? I do. Alright, we're gonna cast Protect on... we'll cast on Dinadin. I could cast React and do another Breath Attack, but I just want them to move forward, so... so they're gonna all act now, because obviously we angered them. Awesome, that's a good position. I can get a good breath attack there. Now I just need them to all form up behind them. Yep, just like that. Solid claw. Okay, my dragon got beat up, but that's fine. Pixie's just gonna hang out. Okay. So yeah, we'll do an acid breath down this way. Good hits. I can do some AoEs, but there's not really much reason to, so I'm not too worried about it. I am gonna go ahead and let's see. I can kill a unit. How close are you to leveling? You're pretty close. Alright, let's go this way. I want to kill that wyvern. It won't do enough damage, but a dragon will be able to finish it off. And yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and fall back. Well, yeah, I'm worried about the rock and the dragon and then just getting ganged up on. How far does this thing go? Six spaces, so one, two, three, four, five. Yeah, that's in range. Yeah, I'm gonna fall back. Go this way. So Mechas is gonna go first. So yep, that's with Protect up. Alright. So yeah, that hurt a lot. So first things first, we're gonna go ahead and Holy Word and hit everything that we can. Alright, I can do a breath attack in place and hit two units, or I can push in and start wrecking face. Let's take you out real quick. Awesome, good hit. Okay. Now the question is can I do enough to kill this thing? Kill Millet? Let's find out. Almost. I can definitely take her out if need be. Let's cast React. We want this on. Yeah, there's no way I'm gonna be able to get over there. Okay. Magic is believing. Even though I lost this battle, I know I will win someday if I keep believing. 24. Alright. If I can hit with this Tiamat, I might be able to have some fun. So let's do React on Tiamat. That's assuming I can get paired all the retreats, but I don't think I can. I don't think that's gonna happen. I can't do another breath attack. I could try to take out Peridol himself. But I think I'd rather try to go for the kill. More than like, well, let's see what happens. Okay, you're gonna move in an attack, that's fine. Alright, you retreated, that's good. Okay, so 204 HP. First things first. Let's see how much damage I can do with you. 74. Okay, I think that might be kill range. I hope it is. Now he He's definitely in kill range. Alright. It's all you, Milia. How could I let you defeat me? You'll pay for that in blood. Level 9, level 10. And we got ourselves a hellhound that I don't need. Level 8, 13, 9, 10, 10, 13. So we got more things we need to class change. Alright, Leonia is attacking us. Not much we can do about it. We do have options. So let's take Boart, Sierra, and of course Cortina. Our first time we're actually defending, so those are just gonna come at us. Not a big deal. Oh, they have Back-to-Backus. Back-to-Backus was originally from Escalio, so they joined Leonia, which is probably not doesn't fit at all, but that's fine. So Back-to-Backus, he is a berserker. This is out of the three classes you can change into, like Crusader, Samurai, or Berserker. Berserker has less defense, but they're really heavy in offense. The Power Glove increases his attack and defense, and he regenerates 5% of his max HP every round. Even after the fall of Escalia, he stayed on the battlefield to keep fighting. He's not very smart, but he's extremely powerful. The way he laughs out loud with his mouth open signifies that he doesn't have any worries. So his character's backgrounds will change if they... You know, if their country falls and they have to switch sides, so that's kind of a nice touch. Isfus. He is a monk. Now, when you level up a cleric, you can either go bishop or you can go monk. If you go monk, you become sort of like a hybrid, where you get sort of like, you're mixed of like a brawler with a little bit of healing magic type thing. The unique thing about monks, though, is instead of having additional crit, they're basic attack actually has a chance of causing paralysis. They do know heal and cure, so they can do support. A smiling giant with a gentle heart who works under Cardinal Paternus. His hobby is gardening and is often seen feeding birds. Isfus acts like a big brother to Pilaf and would put his own life on the line for the queen. And then over here we have Asmit. He is a bishop. He has an Almighty Ring. Almighty Ring increases your strength, int, agility, and that's it, I think. Yep. It might increase defense, but that could be just a result of the agility increase. Just bishop, too special. A wise knight in Leonia, who is also known as the perfect man. His perfectionism usually puts people off, however the queen places complete trust in him. Kalaf may be jealous of him because the queen relies on Asmit on most occasions. Alright, and as far as units, they don't really have much. They haven't been really fighting much, so... I mean, they fought Escalio and then they had to fall back. Alright. So all we're going to do here is we're going to form a front line. Made up of nothing but Jin. Unfortunately, Victoria does not have very... Well, that's not Victoria, sorry. That's Sierra. Sierra doesn't actually have very good rune area, unfortunately. So this is not a super solid front line, obviously, because things don't exactly have good defense. They can evade okay. That's about it. But the AI acts a little weird around Jin. Because they're such a non-threat, sometimes they just don't attack them. In any case, here's our rock. And we'll put our archers over here. So I got off the castle so I could have a fallback point for characters that do get wounded. More than likely, we'll probably try to first strike. Because with this many units, well, this many djinn, we can definitely do some fun stuff with that. Question is can I get range? No, not this round. I can somewhat get in range. How close can I get? I can get to about there. How close can you get? You can get about to there. Yeah, I can't really get a good strike in. I can get a few hits in, but that's about it. I'll tell you what, we're just gonna wait in place and see what happens. Now, I definitely don't want to lose this territory because the network that we're kind of in the middle of will kind of screw us over. Kind of like what happened with Escalio. Alright, we're moving in now. Of course, the big issue is of running out of ammo, because there's only so much MP to go around, but that's okay. So yeah, do this and hit there. Definitely worthwhile to try to get as much bang out of your buck for your djinn. So try to hit multiple targets. And if you see opportunities, take it. Unfortunately, these guys have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 healers. They have the 2 angels, the 2 unicorns, the bishop, and the monk. All with healing spells. Now granted, if they spend actions, you know, healing, they can't hit me, so it's a trade-off I'm willing to take. Here is yep, damage adds up. Definitely adds up. So move in like this. Yeah, that's fine. Then like that. Let's go for Isfas. Oh, critical hit. The critical actually has no chance of causing paralysis, but it still hurts. That's gonna hurt. Wow, crits all around, huh? Well, that centaur's probably dead. Nope, it's not yet. Yeah, we definitely need to focus each target down individually to deal with all the healing, which is fine. So yeah, none of my djinn have counterattacks. Oh. Okay, no paralysis, that's good. And a good counter, that's good. I'm gonna heal her. Okay. They're doing some weird healing. Oh well. Okay. So we definitely want to move up with you. God, your rune area is just awful. So I can definitely hit there. Alright, we'll do this then. Go right there. Okay, that should take care of that. I could attack the angel, but I'm not gonna worry about it right now. That's a really good heal. Alright. Keep up the pressure. Good hits. And pretty much all these djinn, no matter their level, until they have evolved, they are completely expendable. So, can I kill this thing with a Divine Ray? Probably not, but I'll try anyway. Yeah, I was just off. That's okay. Because this djinn will kill it. Like so. So do I want to go after the djinn or the rock? Probably the rock. Okay, so I can get a hit in there. I can definitely hit this djinn here and petrify it. So I don't have to worry about that. Well, let's, I don't know if I can do enough damage, but we can try. Nope. Nowhere near enough. I should have just did frost. That's okay. Still got our level up. Fell back. I guess the good news is since the angels are casting Keel, they're not nuking me with divine rays. So that's a silver lining. Holy cow, look at all that healing. We're about to lose another gen, but that's okay. Oh, you switched targets again. Wow, he even went out of range to get the shot off. No, petrified, that's fine. Okay. There's a few things we can do, I guess. This is gonna put me out of range, but I think I'm okay with that. Level 16, great. I can go after back-to-back is, but that's not really useful. We need to get rid of these rocks. They're still in. That was it, alright. Okay, so what are my options here? Okay. Where would that put us? Right there? Okay, that's fine. So this gen is out of MP, so I'm gonna fall it back. This gin is also out of MP. That MP... Oh wow, everything's out of MP. That's a problem. Okay. Unless I can... Well... If I can heal that gen, I can do something with that, but until then... Also, you're out of MP. Okay, so that's gonna be an issue. It's not the end of the world. Critical hits, good hit. Another good hit. Nine. Oh, petrified. Okay, well that's nice. But I need to make sure you die this time. So, Genofrost. Or not Genofrost, but Frost. I guess I didn't have enough training. Thank you, thank you. Okay, they're all gone now. Alright. Now the question is can I do enough damage in a matter of seconds? There's 87 damage. Well, I can definitely kill that angel, so I might just do that and call it good. Yoink. Fortunately, Asmet's gonna act before Boart will be able to. That's okay, we took out quite a bit of units. We lost a centaur. And I think that was it. I think we only lost a centaur. And that's pretty much my turn, so we'll go ahead and end that. Alright, good stuff. Video went on a bit longer than I expected, but that's okay. Oh, wow. Oh! Apparently this is actually an important quest. What are you doing in a... So what ended up happening is Elliot got lost in the forest and stumbled upon this guy. What are you doing in the forest on a night like this? Elliot explained what has happened. Hahaha, so you're lost in the forest. I'm sorry, and you want to know the way out of the forest? Well, too bad, I can't tell you. Why? I'll tell you why. I'm lost myself, that's why. Ha ha ha. Huh? My name is Hude. I'm an adventurer. There's nothing we can do right now. I guess we'll have to spend the night here. They sat down by the fire and told each other about themselves. As they talked, it became clear that Hude had the ability to be a knight. Loot suggested to Hude that he should apply to become a knight. I don't know how I could be of any help. I only know about adventure. Don't worry. Elot encourages Hude to at least meet Elot's lord. Well, you've convinced me. I'll meet your lord. Next morning, Elot found the way out of the forest with the help of Hude and headed for home. I brought a freelance knight. My name is Hude, the adventurer. I don't like to stay in one place for a long time, and I never had a chance to become a knight before. But from now on, I'll work hard to be of use to you. I'm on my way out to investigate the situation of other countries. You're left on a journey. It looks like Hewitt has joined. Millie, I would like to accompany you when you visit Goosh. You want to visit Goosh? Or Gush? I do not care for him, I just want to keep an eye on him. I don't think it's a good idea to be alone with him. Ha, you don't trust Goosh, huh? Well, I guess it's more fun to travel with someone than to travel alone. Alright, so that's just a hint that you need to send them together on a quest, which is a little annoying, because I don't want to send them on a quest. But it does give us a potential character, I guess, so... that's gonna be a problem. I'll deal with that later. As much as I would love to send him on a quest right now, on a quest together to potentially get another character, it's not really a good idea at this point. Alright, so we're good on that front. I'm gonna go ahead and call it a video for right now, because obviously I've went over time, so I am TheDepressedEwan, and this was Brigandine. See you guys later.